Hi, today Shai and I are going to be talking about loose lead walking. This is part three and we're going to be moving it into everyday life. We're going to be talking about how to get your dog to consistently understand how to do their loose lead walking. Carry on watching, we'll show you how. With loose lead walking, it's really important to remember that consistency is really important, and that's really the most difficult part of teaching your dog to walk on a loose lead. There are lots of different methods for loose lead walking. There are lots of different pieces of equipment to help you with loose lead walking. Some are really good, some are absolutely dreadful, and I wouldn't touch with a barge pole. That really is a video in itself. But with this method, what I say to people is this is the starting point to help your dog to understand about the loose lead walking. Try this method first. If you can say hand on heart that you've tried these methods consistently every day for a month, if they're helping, carry on with them and you will get there. If they're not helping, then we'd need to look at a different way of doing things. But there really isn't a lot of point in trying a different method until you've tried this one first and you really have given it a proper go. Carry on watching and hopefully this will help you.
So we are now on to week three of loose lead walking. Now, please do not think that you're going to reach this stage by week three. You're not. It's a long process and there are lots and lots of different methods of teaching loose lead walking. However, eventually what you're looking to do is to be able to phase out the food treats and only use them in distracting environments that are really distracting. And the dog will begin to learn that there are different rules about how we do this. So for example, if my dogs are pulling their way out of the door because I've done a reasonable amount of being in the house, having rewards, listening to me, that sort of thing, they quite quickly begin to realize we are not leaving the house if you are as high as a kite and pulling. And the only way we get to leave the house is actually with you and listening and with me and calm on a loose lead. Now, Shai started off with a harness and a collar, but we now just use his collar for general sort of everyday walking. There are different pieces of equipment, some very good, some very bad. And so there are other things that we can use if you're struggling, particularly if you've got a very, very young, big, bouncy dog and you're perhaps smaller or not very strong. There are things that we realise you may not be able to manage in just the equipment we've recommended, but there are still other types of equipment we wouldn't recommend. So with a dog like Shai, if he's just got it on his collar, we have taught him, if you're on your collar, you do not pull. If you do pull, I'm not following. And so his life reward, and we're going to be talking about those more on a different day, but his life reward is we get to go on this walk. And that's what you're really wanting. You want to go and explore and sniff. You want to go and have a run through the fields. And we're not going to do any of that if you pull. If you pull, I'm going to stand still and not go anywhere. And so we are going to have a little wander and I'll show you some of the things you can do to keep them guessing. So one of the things that you can do if you think your dog really isn't paying attention is to speed up, slow down, suddenly change direction, Shai. You can use your kissy noise to ask them to give you their attention back. Good boy. You can walk backwards. If they're really surging ahead, then you can actually walk round the front of them. Good boy. That's so nice. And so can you see that he's actually paying attention a lot more? Now, most of the time, I don't particularly want him having to feel he has to pay attention. I want him sniffing, exploring and being a dog, which you can go and do, can't you? Yes. And so I'm quite happy to let him mooch and wander and sniff. That's absolutely fine. While that lead is loose, he knows that he's perfectly allowed to do that. As soon as that lead goes tight, oh, he's staring at my husband behind the camera. Good boy, that's nice. Could you see that when I stood still and the lead went tight, he did that, oh, hang on, this isn't working. We need to find another way of getting this walk to get going again, because when we stand still, unless I'm looking at mum, then things don't continue. Having said all of that, it's important they don't pull, but it's also important that they get to be a dog and they use their noses, they sniff and they explore. Yeah? Good boy. So he has a nice loose lead, and because I'm not having to deal with food treats, I'm quite happy to hold his lead now in the side where he is, because I'm not going to worry about trying not to feed him across my feet. I don't have food on me. He knows the rules, he knows how this works. Hey, you're also looking at all those birds, aren't you? Yeah, good lad.
Thanks for watching this video. I hope that you've enjoyed it. If you have, please click subscribe and so I can help you in further videos. And if any of you click like, a huge thank you, it really does mean a lot. If you think this video can help anyone else, then please feel free to share. See you next time. Bye.